Hi friends, it's me, Simply Sherry, giving you weekly tips and tools to get organized and get prepared. In this video, I'm going to show you my stock up haul from Costco, a 6 month supply of oil, oatmeal, and a few other things. The reason I know that it's a 6 month supply is because I tracked our use of these particular products for 2 months and then for another 2 months. And the reason I use 2 months is because sometimes in 1 month it's a one-off, and so two was more consistent as far as seeing what I could use total in that time. And so that is my suggestion for you, is to track the particular brands that you normally use. It can be from Costco, it can be from any other grocery store, but track it and then multiply it by three and you're going to see your 6 month supply. Or if you track it for 1 month and you multiply it by six, and that's 6 months. Or if you want to start with a 3 month supply, it's the same scenario. Track it, multiply it so that it would equal the 3 months. I suggest that you do this tracking at least for 2 weeks, a month, 2 months. You're going to get a better idea of the products that you're using, how often you're using them up. And so when you multiply it by whatever amount, you know, okay, I have a 3 month supply, I have a 6 month supply. And you can watch all the wonderful YouTube videos or find great information on the internet telling you, you need to store this many pounds of flour for 1 year per person and per day even. And so those are great guidelines, but you can track it by just taking a little bit of time, jotting it down and seeing what you're using up. Then you will know, okay, I've used this for 2 weeks, multiply it by two, it's 1 month's worth. Or I've used this for 1 month, multiply it by three or six, I have a 3 month or 6 month supply. So you get the idea, take the time, track it, because you are storing what you eat and eating what you're storing. Example here, I have 2 64-ounce of mayo. Now, when you see those two bottles, they look like a lot, but this is for 6 months. So it means that we're using one of these within 3 months. So can use it for different recipes, for sandwiches. We don't eat a lot of sandwiches. We don't use a lot of recipes for mayo, but those times that I do need mayo, I like to have it on hand. And so I tracked that and I saw, okay, this is what we need for 6 months. And then we go on here to olive oil. So what I found with olive oil, as far as our use, is that it's sporadic. Some months I use a lot of olive oil, other months I do. Usually during the summer and spring, I use more olive oil. That's for salads and we seem to eat more pasta during that season. Now we're eating more soup and more Asian food. So those are things to consider, but over, let's say, a span of 2 months, or I checked not just in June and July, but also let's say August and September, and I saw this was the average, this would be good enough for 6 months. Then let's go to the canola oil. So this is something I definitely use, and although we try not to use too much oil and we use an air fryer, we still use this much oil. For the canola oil, I definitely wanted to track this because we try to do a Costco run just once a month. In the last few months, I've tried to go as little as possible, but I've still had to go. And so for canola oil, I tracked and I figured out that 2/3 of this container is what we use in a month. So you multiply that by six, it comes out to 4 containers. So even though we air fry and I try not to use as much oil, and then there's lots of recipes I use or make that are not don't require oil, we still use that much oil in a month. So the coconut oil in Costco has been out for a while, but I rarely picked it up. But since this whole lockdown had happened, I started getting some coconut oil, of course, for the prepper pantry. But then my husband wanted to use it for cooking and other things, so I had to track that. And so what I found is that he used one of these for 2 months. So 1, 2, 3, that would be 6 months worth. And then the one extra is for our prepper pantry. We are using a lot of apple cider vinegar, not just for cooking. I'd say for cooking, we would probably use one of these in a whole, let's say, 2 months. And so this would be 6 months worth. And then I have these other three for our prepper pantry, which, you know, you can drink that and once a day and that's good for you. And then they didn't have the brand of ketchup that I usually get, so I'm not sure if they're out or they're no longer stocking that, because I had stocked up a bunch and hadn't looked at ketchup for a while, so I found these, or they had these, so I picked these up, and we go through one of these bottles a month, and so that's only for 3 months. But I wanted to taste this first, make sure it's something that we like before I actually stock up 6 months' worth. All right, my favorite cereal, Honey Nut Cheerios. This is all for me. No one else really eats that. I've already prepared those, what you call that, in mason jars. So those are set for long-term food storage. I also have some in Mylar bags. So I already have that set up. This was more for me to actually eat in the next 6 months. So this is, let's say, 3 months worth and 3 months worth. So, I mean, I eat cereal probably once a week, twice a week, if even. So that's going to last that long. And then I decided to try these because of one of my favorite YouTubers that I've been watching even before 2020, and that's Alaska Prepper. So he said to try this, so I trust him, and I've still yet to try it, but I went ahead and bought 2 boxes. And then we go on to yeast. And remember the time this year when there was no yeast on the shelves, like at all? And so once these came out, I picked up a couple, and then I picked up 2 more. And this is more for my long-term food storage that I'm going to store better than just in these, because these will last. I think the best use date here is, let's see, 10, 22. So that's in 2 years. But I have 2 other packs like this that can be used up. And so these will be for more long-term food storage. All right, something that is always used up here in our household is almond milk. So I got 2 more of these. Again, this was something I had to track because I felt like I was always buying almond milk. And so I found that one of these boxes is good for 1 month. And so that's only 2 months worth, but I have more almond milk that's already stocked up that I did a little while ago. So we're good with that. And then we don't really use a lot of soy milk, but I have to use it sometimes in different recipes because my daughter cannot have nuts. So I have to do a separate recipe if I'm doing one for my son and one for my daughter. And so this is more for recipes and the one-off if I use it for my Nespresso. So I like to use soy milk if I don't have any type of creamer. And then sometimes I use almond milk, but I try to use this so I don't have to use up the almond milk. All right, last but not least, Mr. Quaker Oats. It's always good to see him because we use a lot of oatmeal in this house. And so I got these 4 or 5 pounds, so that's 20 pounds, because I'm actually using this or putting this into a 5 gallon bucket with a Gamma lid. So I might do a separate video just showing how I'm storing things, but this is definitely for that 5 gallon bucket. I have other oatmeal that I've put in mason jars, I have in Mylar bags. These 20 pounds of oatmeal are going to go into that 5 gallon bucket for regular use. It's not for long-term storage. And the reason we're putting that is because I think it'll just save space. And what we do is we're just going to get oatmeal from that 5 gallon bucket, put into our OXO container that's in our pantry, and that's just kind of how we're going to fill it up. And so when the bucket is low, that's when I'm going to replenish the bucket. Because, as I said, oatmeal is something that is used all the time in our house. Again, I can't reiterate enough that you need to track what you're using, the brands you're using, take note, and then you're going to know more specifically and more clearly the things that you're going to use or the things you are using and for the amount of time it's used up. So if it's a 3 month supply you're aiming for, or a 6 month or 1 year, you're going to know how many things you're going to buy, and you can even determine your budget for that. Because if you're going to buy 4 of these times, I think they're like $11 now or $12, then you know it's going to be $48. And the same with things like you use regularly. If you're going to use them up in 6 months, you know that this is what you'll be paying for 6 months, and then you can do it again or buy another stock in another 2 or 3 months or 4 months to make sure you're ahead. Thank you. I hope you enjoyed this video. Let me know in the comments below what you stock up from Costco, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye. All this time you thought we'd never pay the price.